wrote this, "Then I heard a voice from heaven say, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, in the rest from the labor, for their deeds will follow them." And who knows, I've heard a lot of good deeds and good works that have followed Lonnie on to a better place called heaven. Let's open up the word of God. Heavenly Father, we do come before you and we thank you that you are our God, that you are the good shepherd. You have promised to look after your sheep, and we know that Lonnie has been one of yours for a long time. And we know that this family who sits here in grief and sadness and mixed emotion, that they're your children as well. And we know that you promised that you're going to be with us in our corner, especially in these times of sadness. We thank you for Lonnie. We thank you for his words of encouragement to so many people, including me, and being sure here at church, and I would talk with him, and I feel like a better person after I left. And we just know that's the kind of person I was. So we thank you for this family. We thank you for the encouragement and the love that they show to one another. And most importantly, we thank you that you are our God, and that you are strengthening this family through your Holy Spirit. So I pray that you would just continue to bless them and heal them and comfort them as only you can. And we pray for your Holy Spirit to let you to guide us. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
For the day in the sky, our surrounded faces, of people passing by, so frail, shaken, and I see, how do you do? They make us say, I love you.
Great comfort in the presence. promises of God. But what about us and family members and grandkids, little ones running around here? What is it for us who are still on this journey? Are there promises for us? Yeah, there are. We can be assured that we too will be led to victory if we trust in Christ, if we put our faith in Him, if we obey Him. Death may seem to hide His face temporarily, but His promise is to be with us always, even to the end of the world. Corrie ten Boom, who suffered horribly in the Nazi concentration camps and lost her sister, lost her family in these terrible places. This is what she said. She said, when a train goes through a tunnel and it gets dark, you don't throw away your ticket and jump off. You sit still and you trust the engineer. Our lives have an engineer. Lonnie, he had an engineer. And we can trust Him who said, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. I believe that in eternity, God makes all things right. How do you know? The past few years, he's struggled with health issues and different things like that, but all things are right now. He promises that He will wipe away tears from your eyes, that there will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain or problems in the brain or whatever it is. It says for the old order of things, it's all passed away. In the meantime, we have to be faithful. Can't change the past. It's over. So let me say this. There's some issues in life that we will not understand until eternity. And I've told people so many times, even Christian families, that I've done so many funerals and I still do not have an understanding of death. It's just, we know it's going to happen, but it's so final. It's hard to grasp the finality of death. But I urge you in this time of disappointment to release, if you have any questions, any doubts, whatever, release that to the Lord. In the words of the old hymn, put your burden to the Lord and leave it there. Because Jesus said, come unto me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I'll give you rest. One day the Lord will answer all of our questions that we have for Him. But in the meantime, we need to make and do our best to trust Him so that our hearts are not so troubled in times like this. And you and I can find that the same faith which led Lonnie home can bring comfort to us as well. We've all sung this hymn before. Through many dangers, toils, and snares I already come. 'Twas grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. And that's what led Lonnie home. He's home, and it will be for us as well if we have trust in the Lord. I was talking to Elaine on the phone, and the image comes to my mind all the time now. And we lose loved ones, and we've lost a lot within this church in the past couple of years, and now Ronnie's gone to a better place. But I lost my dad last year, and I just know when Ronnie got there, his loved ones were waiting for him. Like Elaine said, with a pie, I think so. Ronnie was up there, whoever was making the pie for him, and I told her, I said, I bet my dad was up there too. His dad knew Ronnie. He'd been here before that as well. That's the way it is with him. But about a little news story. Thinly clad, drenched to the skin by the soaking rain, stood shivering in the doorway one cold day in November. First one bare foot and then the other was lifted for a moment and pressed against his legs, just trying to find a little warmth. Every few minutes, his shrill cry could be heard, morning papers, morning papers. And a gentleman who was well protected by his coat and umbrella stopped by the early edition and noticing the boy's discomfort, he said that this kind of weather's pretty hard on you, isn't it? And looking up with a cheery smile, the youngster replied, I don't mind too much, mister, because the sun will shine. That's Christ's promise to each one of us as well. Every exit is but an entrance. When we leave this place in a few moments, whatever door you go out, I want you to look at the sign above. I want you to always remember, every exit, there's an entrance. Christ is faithful to His promises. He has promised us that in His Father's house are many rooms. And he has promised us that in our times of need, he's not going to leave us. He's not going to forsake us. I know there are clouds now. I know that there will be more tears come, especially when you're alone in your thoughts. But in Ramah's new home, the sun is shining. It will shine, and someday it will shine again for us. I'm going to play another song at this time. Savior that has promised that he will take us home, and that's what we presence and the presence of loved ones who have gone under the grave. We thank you, Father, for being a God that's promised that you are going to continue to look out for us. So I pray that you would just wrap your compassionate arms around this family, that you would love them and encourage them in the days and the weeks ahead, and when night falls and they're laying down their pillow and their tears are streaming, I pray that you would remember them to realize that although we miss lying here, we have so much to look forward to, and that's what peace experience in right now. We thank you for the promise of heaven. We thank you for your promise of grace and mercy and forgiveness that you bestow on us every single day. Again, lift up this family, and we pray that you would just bless them, that you would also bless our time of fellowship as we go back to the Bible. And we pray for these things and pray for Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.